I got something very special for you. I want to show off something that I've developed right here. Now, if you've seen my videos, you know I like to design stuff. But one thing that I don't really talk about is I like, a personal thing about me is I like to shoot black powder firearms. Anything along the line from muzzle loaders, cat and ball revolvers, cowboy action shooting, all that. That's my own little personal fascination. So today I'm going to show off this little tool that I developed. It's a new paper cartridge former. Makes it very convenient. It offers one of these out. These little cartridges with a weakened base, so it can have real good ignition. The primer can puncture that, burn the powder very quickly. The paper I'm using is newsprint paper. It's about twice the thickness of cigarette paper, but still half the thickness of normal paper. So, get this set up. I'm going to show you how to use it. So first thing I'm going to do is pull out all the little pieces that I need. It is a little windy today, as you just saw. Put my little conical right there. Pull out a wall. Now these here are laser cut. I created my own template that would work with this. It does work with cigarette paper. It's a little bit more finicky, but it does work. As you can see here, got that. Apply the glue. Turn it. Let it dry. I'm gonna see if the wind dies down just a little bit so I can get this base on. I think now's my chance. The base right there. There we go. You got the tube formed. It was that easy. Now, pull this off. Put it into the opposite side. This here, the body doubles as like a holder so that I can pour the powder in and put the ball or conical on. Ball. These are 451 round balls. I just lost my walls. Push that in. Cover this glue up. Now, pull this baby out. Paper cartridge. I'm going to do two more. I'm going to do a conical and another ball. But this time I'm going to talk about things. You know, some of my thoughts of when it came to designing this. I'm going to grab this one, put it in here in my little paper cartridge and capper box. And then I'll be right back. I got to hunt down the thing that blew away. Alright, I'm back. So this time I want to talk about the actual concept. So I got the former, and I got O-rings. The O-rings is meant to grip the paper and feed it in, which I believe does quite well. Now the shape of the paper, I laser cut it so it can create this tube every time and yet have a little flap. This will be your glue flap. Now, oh my gosh, there's a lot to cover. In the back, I put this hard flat surface so that you can apply glue. And you don't have to struggle trying to get it to glue onto the tube. So at this point, you know, on a normal former, you'd have to hurry up and try to get it all on there. But as you can see here, I'm taking my time, turning it. And I just let it set. See, I'm not applying pressure to the tube. The former is doing that for me. And I can just set it down at any time and do whatever else I need to let that glue. So I'm not struggling to form it. I'm not struggling to apply pressure to get it to glue. Like there is no hassle. It's super simple. You know, I just give it a couple turns, give it a couple seconds, and it's good. Now for the, this is the perfect time. Not a single gust of wind. This here, as you can see, one side is weakened, has a little brown dot, and then the other side, it's clear. You would put that in there, and there's like a little dip for it to go in. This helps it keep it centered so that when you put the tube on, it centers the hole every time. And now for the wings, how it has all those legs around it. There we go. Just push that in there. All these legs, they perfectly wrap around the cylinder, the tube. So there's not overlapping sheets. Everything is side by side. The more sheets that overlap, the harder it gets to burn. But because I eliminate any overlapping sheets, it burns pretty well. Now, I'm not saying it burns every time. There's a good, I want to say 95-98% of this burns. What really doesn't burn is how much glue I apply. Too much glue, it won't burn, you know, because you gotta use a trick type of glue. This is, this works, but it's not the best. Let's see what else. After I formed it, obviously I added this little hole in the base, and this here holds it in place so I can apply the powder and the projectile. Now, I did this so that I don't have to apply pressure to the tube and hold it in my hand. So I can squeeze this as much as I want, and I'm not gonna deform the tube at all. But it holds it just in place to where I can pretty much hold it upside down and it won't fly out. This is so I can get a good, easy pour. See? Put a lot of thought into this. This took me almost a year of trial and error to get it to come out right. Hopefully the wind don't blow that away. I'd be very disappointed if it does. So now we're gonna do a conical. This one here is 450 conical, and I dimensioned it so it can fit in perfectly. Look at that. Look at that. Look at that. Perfect every time. every time. Super easy. So now I'm gonna do one more. This time, I'm gonna see. Lost the bases again. How quickly I can do it. My last one, so we'll just see how quick I can do it. I'm not gonna go super fast, but we'll just see. Okay, so I got everything set up. Grab my wall. Feed it in. Hold the flap. Grab my glue. Turn it. Put that down. I don't know why I covered my glue, because I gotta use it again. That's it. All done. Look at that. I don't know how long that took. I didn't time it, but isn't that nice? All of them look identical. Alright. Gotta clean this up. Okay, yeah. So this here is the paper cartridge former, which I made, which is very, very cool. I got in a 44 and a 36, and now I am working on the rifle versions, and it's going to be a lot different than what this looks like right now. So if you want to see the rifle version whenever I can get that finished and come out, feel free to subscribe, follow, stay tuned for the future, because we're going to have a lot more cool versions. Okay, that's it.